Namaste to everybody. Welcome back again. And we are joined here by Sunil Jani Pawar. And Sunil is an expert in Jyotish Shastra that I have known. I have learned a lot from her. So today, I have invited her to speak about a very important topic because everybody knows about this, but nobody knows the applications and how important the subject is. Today we're going to discuss about Navamsh, which is the ninth, you know, divisional chart. So Sunilji, welcome and namaste. So Sunilji, you know, everybody talks about Navamsh, okay? But typically nobody knows what is the importance and how to use the Navamsh. So what has been your experience and how do you look at Navamsh? Please help us, you know, understand this concept of Navamsh and why amongst all the Varka charts, Navamsh is more important.
Yeah, in Vimshoka Kupal also 6 marks have been given to Navamsh. Basically, now many people are becoming aware about the Navamsh chart. So for this credit goes to Sri C.S. Patel sir, who has written wonderfully about the Navamsh. Even in VPHS also, many good facts and I should say techniques are mentioned, but those techniques has to be decoded. You know, everything is written, but everybody takes a different meaning out of that, apart from the basic meaning of the Navamsh chart. Navamsh chart, as you said, is a nine divisions of one house. In Navamsh chart, basically why it is called as Navamsh, it is also called as Gopansh also. It is called as, so many names are given to this Navamsh chart, Navamsh, Navamesh, you know. Navratna also many people are nowadays calling it. Why they are calling it? Because whatever planets we are born with in the D1 chart, that is Kshetra Kundali, Lagna Kundali. So in D9 also some planets are going to come. All Varga charts, all the planets are going to be placed in a different house or in the same house. So whenever planets are posited in the Navamsh after the division degreekali, in what houses they are placed in the D9 chart and what is the capacity and strength of that planet, we come to know from the D9 chart. For example, in your D1 chart, any planet is in debilitated position. So immediately one should not become disturbed, or many people are writing in the comments also, you know, every time that, no, I have a debilitated planet, but it is nothing like that. In D9 chart, if same debilitated planet is becoming exalted, we have seen in so many charts this is happening. Or same planet is of friendly sign, or same planet is of own Rashi. In D9 chart, definitely fruits will vary. So at least out of 100, this planet will give at least 50 to 60% marks to that person. But when fruits they will achieve, when the proper Mahadasha Antardasha comes. It doesn't mean that all the life these fruits will be given. Particularly in that period, these fruits will be experienced. Same way, if in D9 chart, any planet you see in debilitation position, many people ask the same question. No, in my D9, this planet is debilitated. What is the fruit of that? So now see the same planet position in your D1 chart. That is Lagna Kundali. So you have to assess both the kundalis at the same time. Whenever we are assessing the chart, so D9 chart here becomes very, very, very important to know the actual strength of any planet, including Rahu Ketu. Rahu also may become exalted. Ketu also may become exalted in D9 chart. Second thing, if in your D1 chart, certain things are not promised. Say, my house is, I'm planning to buy a house or property, but it is not happening. But if in D9 chart, it is promised in the chart. So definitely the person will buy a house with the strength of Mars and Saturn in D9 chart also, even though these planets are not promising in D1 chart. Okay. Another thing by Naumansha chart, why Naumansha technique is used? Many people go for Rashi Tulya Naumansha or Naumansha Tulya Rashi. Okay. So this is the wonderful technique we can use, which we are going to also take in our webinar of Naumansha, which is going to take place. So in that also we will discuss about this technique, how to use this technique, Rashi Tulya Naumansha, Naumansha Tulya Rashi. Also the other techniques we will be using, like using the Nadi Amsha. These techniques are used in Sarvatobhadra Chakra also, in Nadi Shastra also, in VTHS also, in our Shastra also, these techniques are mentioned. Only we have to take the basic concept out of it and decode it. D9 chart basically, as I said, is the strength of the planet. At the same time, in Gochar also we can use the D9 chart. You know, transit also D9 using becomes very, very important. And if one has to or needs to go for deep research or something apart from or above the predictions, then charan wise also you can read the D9 chart. Whatever charan you are born in, so that charan, you come to know that this charan, if it is a Mars, then you see the Mars position in D9 chart also. So that period, that degree, whenever the Gochara planet, whenever the transit planet comes over the same planet posited in D9 in the same degree, say for example 2 degrees in your D1 chart, so in D9 chart, whenever Gochara planet of say for Mars, 2 degree Mars. So whenever 2 degree will exactly be in the Gochara, that time see the fruit of that house in D9. So many things you also have the so many techniques of nakshatra using in the D9 chart. You know, with nakshatra also we can decode so many things in D9 chart. And I feel that it is must and very much necessary to assess the chart with the help of Naumansha chart. So this is the thing one has to, out of all 16 Varga charts, I give more and more importance to Naumansha chart along with Chalit Kundali also. Chalit Kundali, many have confusion that when to see the Chalit Kundali, that is how Chalit Kundali. So I believe that whenever the planets are of Sandhi degrees, last degrees, so definitely in D9 also the position will get changed because of that. So that time also, to know the strength of the planet, you can refer to Bhavchalit Kundali as well as Naumansha Kundali. If any planets are in Sandhi Lagna or Sandhi degrees, means last degrees or very initial. So this is what I feel about the Naumansha, to know the actual capacity of the planet and how this planet will give you fruit as per its karakatva and as per its dasha, how the events in our life will take place in all the life cycle, in all the way. Arjunji.
No, I think these are fantastic points that you have brought up, you know, Sunilji ji. I think there is a lot of research that has been done, as you mentioned, by you know, Chandubhai Patel, C.S. Patel. And C.S. Patel's book on Naumansha is actually a Bible. And you know, some of the techniques that I have seen that they work very well, like Rashi Tulya Naumansha, Rashi where Rashi as the Lagna of the Naumansha, and then you know, vice versa, and then you see the chart. And essentially for all of those people, what I want to say is Rashi, or as you said, Kshetra Kundali or Rashi Kundali or the D1 chart, it is more like the tree.
Yes.
Okay. And Naumansha is the fruits of the tree.
Yes.
Okay, so if you really want to know how the fruits are, obviously you can't look at the fruits by without looking at the tree. So that is why I feel many of us will have to use them in combination. You cannot read one chart, you know, without the other.
Yes.
But there are other ways of techniques of looking at the D9 chart as an individual chart separate.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, in South, they mostly concentrate on D9 chart.
In the South, if you go to a Pandit in the villages, they will not even look at your D1 chart. They will always look at the D9 chart. And maybe the D12 chart, Dwadashang chart.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So, but I feel, you know, even if you know the D1 and the D9, where I have seen, and maybe we'll be discussing this in the webinar that we are going to have, that's where I am more interested in knowing the concepts of Nadi Amshas.
Yes.
Beautifully described in Chandrakala Nadi, where you can see there are some Nadi Amshas which have been given. I think, this is some beautiful techniques that you can use. Beautifully given. But what generally I do when I see Amshas is I look at what is the relative position of the planet in the D1 and the D9. That gives a lot of clues. And although I have to say, there's no mention in the classics of using in the divisional charts, you're not using nakshatras. Yes, there is no mention about it, because it is as though the Varga charts, you cannot further divide it. Because they are divided in the sky. You know, the sky is divided as per nakshatras, and that division of the zodiac is happening. And many scholars do believe, no, there is no way of, you know, dividing the Varga charts. Correct? But what I feel personally, and this is through my own experience, I feel they work wonderfully.
Hmm.
Although it is not there in the classics, and maybe, you know, even technically it might not sound correct, but all I try to do is, if a planet is sitting in a particular nakshatra, okay, in the D1 chart, its energies are going to go into a particular amsha in the navamsha.
Right.
Okay. So in there, what is the transformation of the planet is happening? I'm moving from one nakshatra to that nakshatra in the D9.
Hmm.
The evolution. How will the planet evolve?
Hmm.
Study very closely. You will get some fantastic clues. And you know, although it might not be there in the classics, and maybe as per even the logic, maybe you might not be able to use that in the Navamsha, because otherwise you have to use the in the Navamsha. You just look at the which bhava it has gone and which rashi it is in. More so with the bhava. So I find that definitely has something. And then that is the another question I had for you was, when you said transits, when you look into the Vamsha, I want to ask you the fundamental question. Do you look at the transit in the Navamsha, or do you look at the transit? What is happening? Say, suppose it is now Jupiter is transiting, let us say 2 degrees of Sagittarius. So in the Navamsha also, do you think 2 degrees of Sagittarius, or do you look at the Navamsha where it has gone? Like for example, if it is 2 degrees, maybe it is in Aries Navamsha.
Jupiter,
yeah. So do you look at the transit in the Aries Navamsha, or do you look at in the Navamsha chart, do you look at still 2 degrees of Sagittarius?
No, in Navamsha, wherever the Aries sign is placed, I will see the transit in that house.
That house, okay. So,
along with D1 also you have to see the, because see, in unless and until it is a Vargottama chart, as everybody knows, so when the same house is maintained, that is a Bhav Vargottama, or when same planet in D1 also in D9, in same house, in same Rashi, it becomes Vargottama. Unless and until it is there, apart from that, if any different lagna or different signs, any planets are posited, you have to assess the chart in that way only. How you are reading the D1 chart, you have to assess D9 chart in the same way, because maybe the fruits are not seen in D1 chart as per the transit, but in D9 chart maybe these things are promised. But whatever we are expecting in D1, say for example the Mesh Rashi Aries sign in D1 is coming in 5th house.
Correct.
So if we are expecting the childbirth or education or say any admission or creativity or anything, shares or anything related to 5th house, but fruits are not gained. But if this same Mesh Rashi Aries sign is coming in the 8th house, in D9 chart, so maybe if Jupiter is more stronger in D9 chart, so it will give fruit of 8th house.
Okay.
It will not give fruit of 5th house.
5th house, okay.
So 8th house related matter, maybe that person will get sudden wealth from the ancestor or from the family
insurance
wealth.
Yeah, insurance or inheritance.
Or sudden loss also person may suffer, or any type of health issues also may occur, not necessarily always. But then you have to assess the chart properly. This is all generalized ideas, how to assess the chart in D9. So definitely we will discuss that also, that how to assess the D9 chart properly, to know the exact fruit of D1 chart also, because D9 chart is an X-ray.
Yes, definitely. I agree with you.
D1 is a body.
Yeah.
So X-ray is needed if you want to know the exact reason for particular event, or exact reason when, or exact time when things will happen. Definitely D9 will help a lot.
I think, you know, in a better way, if you have to put, you know, the D1 is like the body of the car that you see. It might be a Ferrari, it might be a Mercedes, it might be a BMW, or it can be any other car. But what is the engine inside? What is happening? Happening is seen from the D9.
Exactly.
So, you know, just don't go by the outer look and decide that, you know, it is, but maybe the inside is what the function is.
Yes, D9 is a soul.
The soul.
D9 is a soul. It is a heart of the main Kundalini. You know, that is why South people directly see only D9. So there is a bigger reason for it. It is not like that they like D9, that is why they are reading it.
Correct.
Because they are getting fantastic result out of it, and they even do not feel a need to see to D1 chart also, because they consider it a soul Kundalini.
Correct. Yes.
They consider it as a heart of that person's planets. And where the treatment is needed, where the surgery is needed, or where the soothing of the things are needed, will be decided from the D9.
Beautiful.
This is very, very much. I'm writing one book on now, Masha.
Wow. By the way. That would be a fantastic book that everybody should have.
Let's see now, mostly by this year, and I'll finish it. I'm writing all the techniques. Easy techniques in that, in two languages I am writing it.
Excellent, excellent.
Hindi and English both.
Both. So yes. I think some of those techniques you will be discussing in this webinar that we have.
Yes, done. Definitely. Definitely. We will be discussing Nadiyamsha in D9 webinar, and we will be discussing the Rashi Tulya Naumansha and Naumansha Tulya Rashi also. As per the time permits, at least idea about it will be definitely given. And if after that, if the good if things are going good, then we can talk on voter also.
Yeah.
How to assess the chart.
So we'll do that. And I also want to, maybe, you know, in the classes, I want to discuss more about Nidanamsha and Ashtamamsha. It's very key, and which has been given also in the book by C.S. Patelji.
Yes, yes.
So that is another thing that I have been observing very much.
Eighth house matter. That is useful for all of us also as astrologers.
Correct. Okay, so brilliant. Thank you very much. And I look forward to, you know, be part of this, you know, course that you're going to do, a webinar. It's a short course for 2.5 hours or 2 hours, I think 2 hours. And she's going to cover all these concepts that about Lakshmanas in that with examples.
Yes.
So thank you very much for coming down.
Thank you so very much, and welcoming all to attend the webinar. So register it soon.
Yes. Registration. Yeah. Oh. They're open for all of them. They can go to Cosmic Insights, and the link is provided just after this video. You can always go and register for this.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. Namaste.